Help all kids learn and grow with PBS Kids. Thank you for supporting your PBS station.
Word up, it's Word Girl. Word up, it's Word Girl. Flying at the speed of sound, vocabulary that sounds from the planet lexicon. Watch her villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check.
Today's featured words are resolution and massive.
It's December 31st, New Year's Eve, and that means it's time to have a...
massive party!
I'll hang the party decorations!
I'll cook up some of my famous New Year's guacamole.
I'll be in charge of the tunes.
Games! I'll be in charge of games!
Oh, wait! Everybody stop! We forgot the most important thing about New Year's! To make a resolution!
Resolutions, of course!
Of course! Yeah! Hey, Becky, what's a resolution?
A resolution is a promise we make with ourselves. If there's something we want to change about ourselves or do better, we make a promise to do that starting in the new year.
Ah, yeah! I still don't get it.
Everybody, think of your resolutions while we get set up!
Meanwhile, across town, in Dr. Two Brain's lair, the henchmen are planning their own New Year's Eve party.
Here you go, Charlie. It's the best I could do on short notice. But don't worry, we're gonna have a great New Year's party. Look, I got us some fruit punch, and we can listen to music and...
What is this, a party?
Hey, boss, we figured since it was New Year's Eve that we could throw a party.
Well, you figured wrong. Sorry to bust your bubble, bumblers, but we've got work to do. My biggest cheese crime ever isn't gonna commit itself.
Biggest crime ever? Tonight?
Tonight?
Yes, tonight! This plan is huge! Epic! Massive! And we're gonna need to get up very early to pull it off. So no staying up late and no parties. I want all henchmen well rested.
But boss, it's New Year's Eve. It's a holiday.
I don't care if it's both your birthdays and National Cheese Day rolled into one. I'll wake you when it's crime time. Until then, it's Betty Bye time. Go, 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 go.
We can still make New Year's resolutions. You know, my resolution? To have more parties.
I heard that.
Meanwhile, at the best New Year's party ever...
Yo, 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 TJ the DJ on the boombox tonight, keeping you feeling fine till 11:59.
I want to hear your resolutions. You go first, Tim.
Oh, my resolution is to be healthy next year. So I'm going to start by jogging each and every morning at dawn.
Oh, good one, hon.
What's your resolution, Mom?
I'm going to help the environment.
Go green!
Well, my resolution is to make the Word Girl International Fan Club even bigger. I want to take it from being international to being intergalactic.
And how are you going to do that exactly?
I'm gonna find some aliens who like vocabulary words. I've got a telescope, so it shouldn't be that hard.
What about you, Bob? What's your resolution? To eat a massive amount of guacamole. Well, good luck with that.
Hey, what's your resolution, Becky?
You know, I thought a lot about it, and my resolution is to hang out with you guys more often and not be running around all the time. It's fun spending time with my family.
Oh, Becky, that's sweet.
It's time for the countdown!
It's almost the new year!
Dark cat!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
Okay, gang, time for bed.
Hold it here, boys. Ah, there you are, you soon-to-be tasty, massive, cheesy marble in the sky.
Say, what's the big plan anyway, boss? You said this was gonna be your biggest crime ever.
Well, using our mega cheese ray, we can turn the moon into cheese. Then I'll use the tractor beam ray to pull the moon down to us. Then we feast on that moon of cheese. You like it? Oh, no, what's wrong?
Well, Charlie and me really wanted to have a New Year's Eve party. It's part of our New Year's resolution, have more parties.
Who cares about your resolution? I'm the boss here, and my resolution is to pull off this massive moon heist. And it's all set. Show me moon cheese! The moon is made of cheese!
No party for us this year. Still feeling stuffed from the party, huh? Well, you did eat a massive amount of guacamole.
It sounded like you said someone turned the moon into cheese. Wait, what? Someone turned the moon into cheese? But who would want to do... Dr. Two Brains! Word up! Are you sure you're ready to battle Two Brains and his henchmen? Top form, huh? One more try.
All right, boys. It's a lovely night to reel in the moon. I'll need to sit at these tractor beam controls for the rest of the night.
What do you want us to do?
I want you to stand guard. Are you even listening? You're thinking about parties, aren't you? Stand guard and make sure nobody messes with the tractor beam. You don't want to go out on New Year's. It's amateur night. I'm going in. Ta-ta!
This might take a while, cause the moon is so, missive? What did the boss call it?
Maybe he called it massive, as in really, really big and heavy.
Word girl!
Let's get him, Huggy! You sure you're ready to battle? All right.
Listen here, Word girl. Either you let Charlie go, or we turn your monkey friend into a big chunk of cheese.
Looks like I've got no choice. I surrender! Not exactly how I saw my New Year's Day turning out.
Did you make a resolution?
Yeah, I resolved to spend more time with my family, oh well.
Charlie, we've got company.
What's going on here?
We're here with Dr. Two Brains on official criminal business. What are you three doing here?
Well, my New Year's resolution is to be healthy, so I got up early to go on a sunrise jog.
Woo! And my resolution is to recycle more, and so the recycling center's on the way! Go green!
And what are your New Year's resolutions?
To have parties, but our boss won't let us.
Well, if you want to have a party, I'd be happy to give you these party decorations. You can recycle them when you're done!
Hold on, Mom. Let's make it a trade. We'll give you the party. party decorations, and I'll be the DJ for your party if you let Wordgirl and Huggy go free.
Oh, I can't decide what to do. Party it is!
Well, yes, it's almost here. Here, Mooney Mooney. Yummy! Oh, it's so exciting. I can almost hear lunar music. Wait a minute. Oh, no. Don't tell me.
This is the greatest party ever!
Glad we could help out!
What in the name of cheese is going on here?
We're keeping our New Year's resolution, boss. We promised ourselves we'd have a massive party, so we're having a massive party.
No, 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 no parties! We are so close to finishing my biggest crime ever! No! Don't turn the cheesy moon into normal moon!
Cheesy Moon is back to normal moon.
Oh, come on. You crushed my hopes and dreams and then you gotta tie me up?
Thanks for letting us go, henchman. You did the right thing.
We're gonna get in big trouble, but it was worth it. That was a really fun party.
Where's that music, DJ?
And so, with the moon back up in the sky where it belongs, all is well this New Year's Day. And if you make one resolution today, it should be to tune in for the next massively exciting episode of Wordgirl.
Happy New Year! Happy New Year!
And this is...
May I have a word?
As usual, the player who correctly defines today's featured word will win a fabulous prize. Let's play!
May I have a word?
Yes, you may. Today's featured word is perspire. To give you a clue, here are some clips from Wordgirl that show the meaning of the word.
Perspire means to sweat, like everyone in those clips was doing.
That is correct! Huggy, show him what he's... Are you okay? Can't you find a better time to train for your unicycle race? Oh, Huggy, did you break the air conditioner?
Are you gonna tell me what I've won?
Fine. Here's hoping it's a replacement air conditioner. Huggy, are you ready to show him the prize? Okay. Tommy, you are today's winner! Huggy, show him what he's won! An official Wordgirl absurdly large launch round! Don't worry, folks. He's fine. Okay, that's it for today's episode. See you next time on...
May I have a word?
Listen for the words performance and ruse. It's a beautiful day at the city park, and Becky Botsford is helping her best friend Violet with a... what is this again? Some kind of performance art thing?
Violet, explain again what we're doing here.
We're going to put on a big performance using the three P's. Paintings, poetry, music.
You mean music, so two P's and an M.
However you see it. Okay, our performance will tell the story of a snail and a seashell that start on one side of the ocean and end up on the other. But really, it's about the importance of friendship.
Help! Mr. Big is using mind control on people at the library, and he's doing it above a whisper. Help!
Hey, Violet. I just realized that I totally forgot to brush my teeth.
Ew. Yes, go brush.
Yeah, total morning breath over here. So I'll be right back, okay?
As long as you hurry, Becky. We still have to rehearse the poetry and musical parts of the performance.
Right, wouldn't want to miss the music. Let's go, Bob.
That's right. Do everything I say. And you too can take control of your mind, your life, and your happiness. You'll find out how in my new book, Practicing Mind Control. Oh, it's about the power of positive thinking. Not illegal mind control. And it's on sale now.
Oh, hi,
Word Girl. Are you here to join the crowd?
Not much of a crowd.
It's a grassroots campaign. Leslie?
Wow, this Mr. Big Guy's really onto something. I'm gonna buy one book for myself and one for a friend.
Keep it up. I think we almost got him.
What are you up to, Mr. Big?
What do you mean, up to? I simply wrote a book based on my years of wanting to write a book. And I think it can really help people.
Wait, you expect me to believe that you're not getting anything out of this?
Of course I am. Whenever I sell a book, I get money. So if I sell lots of books, I get lots of money. Mwahaha! 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 You know, the muhahas aren't really as fun when I'm doing something legal. Oh, well. Hey, would you like to buy a book?
Oh, hi, Becky. I'm glad you're back. I couldn't put on this performance without your help.
Of course. What are friends for if not doing all this stuff?
I know. Your friendship inspired me to add a line to my poem.
Really? That's so nice, Violet.
It goes like this. There once was a...
Help! Mr. Big is using mind control and he's...
Someone's reading a poem over here. And Mr. Big isn't using mind control at the library. He's just trying to sell his book.
Wait, how did you know that?
I have no idea.
But he's not at the library. He's at the bank.
Okay, where was I?
I don't want to leave, but that does sound suspicious. Maybe I was right about Mr. Big's book being part of a ruse.
The best friends are always there when you ask, like my best friend Becky, who...
Has to go right now, but I will be right back as soon as I...
No.
Huh?
Becky, I really need your help. You made a promise to help me today, and now you're breaking that promise.
I know. I feel really bad about having to leave again.
Mm-hmm.
But I just really need to leave, and I can be right back.
Fine.
Hey, I know when you say it like that, it means not fine.
The performance starts at 5. Please don't be late.
No way! Hey, me and you, the snail and the seashell, right? Yay! Be back soon! Okay, Bob, let's go.
The artist is alone again.
Take all of these. Yes, take that. And that. Take all of these. Then don't forget to tell all your friends to buy their own copies at the local bookstore. So that's pretty... Hey, Word Girl. It's you again.
That's enough, Big. I know this book thing has to be a ruse. I've never known you to give anything away for free.
Oh, yes. It's part of my new marketing strategy. Give it away and then they'll pay. Would you like a book?
Oh, no thanks. But wait! Why are you giving away books at a bank, huh? Explain that. I know. I totally got him there.
Good question. I'm at a bank because I want people to think about how much money they'll have after they read my book and start practicing mind control.
I know this is a ruse. It's one great big ruse.
I want to disagree with you, but I don't know what a ruse is.
Oh, a ruse is a plan to trick people. Like in this case, you say you're just trying to sell books, but I think that's a ruse and you really have some other evil plan.
What? Well, you just do not know me at all. You should really read my book.
I have to admit, you're not committing any crimes... yet. So I guess we should get back. I mean, it's already... Uh-oh! 1:05! The performance!
Looks like my trick worked, Leslie.
You mean your ruse?
That too.
Mwaha, mwaha, mwaha.
Hey, stop listening to my laughs for free.
I can't believe she thought you were doing something nice, sir. How ridiculous.
Exactly.
Excuse me, everyone. I have a very important announcement to make. If we can all turn our books to chapter 2, controlling our minds. Leslie?
Mwaha, mwaha, mwaha.
Good one, sir.
I know.
Violet, before you say anything, I am so sorry I'm late. You're a great friend to me, and I should have been here for you like you asked. And I hope I can make it up to you in the performance, which I'm sure will be excellent. And I'm sorry again. Did I mention I was sorry? I'm here now, and nothing can possibly take me away.
Don't help. Everything will be fine if you buy Mr. Big's mind control book. Don't help.
I have to go.
What? Becky, you can't. What about all that stuff you just said? The performance is happening now. You promised.
It's just that I have to... Oh, no excuses. Here's the truth, Violet. You're my best friend in the world, and the whole universe, trust me. And I feel really bad for letting you down. The only reason I'm leaving is that I have some other friends who are in real trouble, and they need my help. I wish I could tell you why, but I just...
I look away. You don't have to. Friends don't have to explain everything to each other, Becky. I trust you. Thank you for being honest.
You are the best friend ever. Crush you!
Crushed!
Well, I promise I'll be back soon, and we'll put on a great show, even if it's just for that guy there.
You will spend all your money on Mr. Big's book. You will tell your friends.
Wordgirl,
what are you doing here?
No, not you.
No, not you.
Leslie, make them stop.
Want to tell me again how this book thing was not a ruse?
Well, what can I say? That's the power of good writing, right?
No, it's the power of mind control.
Okay, it was a ruse. Ruse. And it worked. Because once everyone in town has a copy of my book, they will be under my spell. I am so... Rosy!
that is not how you use the word, Mr. Big. Anyway, I'm here to stop you!
Stop me? I've already given away hundreds of these books, and my assistant, Leslie, will never give up the remote.
You know what? This always ends the same way. Just take it.
What? Leslie! What? Well, that's the last thing you should have done.
Well... I thought I tricked you, so I didn't really prepare a big battle or anything. So how about I just,
Ha! Great job, Huggy. Now I'll just press the button to uncontrol these minds and... Actually... Ahem. You will go see Violet's performance in the park! Performance is a show of some kind. It can be music, poetry, dance, or in my friend Violet's case, a little bit of everything. You'll see.
But through all the waves and storming weather, the men across the ocean together.
Hey, where are we?
I don't know, but I like this song.
Everything worked out pretty well. Wordgirl discovered Mr. Big's ruse, and Violet's performance was a big success. That song is pretty catchy, too. Join us next time for another exciting, awesome, incredible episode of Wordgirl!
Wordgirl!
Hello, I'm Bo Handsome, and this is the bonus round of...
May I Have a Word?
our returning champion will have a chance to play for even greater prizes on the bonus round. Tommy, you correctly defined the word perspire. Are you ready to play the bonus round?
Let's do it.
Take a look at these three pictures and tell me which one shows the definition for perspire. A shot, Tommy.
I'm going to go with number three. The DJ in that picture was really perspiring. He was sweating almost as much as you are now.
Tommy, you are our bonus round winner. Show him what he's won, Huggy. Official Word Girl frozen treats. See you next time on
May I Have a Word.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Word Girl saves the city from the evil Dr. Two Brains.
You know, for hardened criminals, they can be so cute.
It's just another day on the job for our favorite pint-sized superhero. Watch Word Girl on PBS Kids Go. Word up.
Favorite word, what's your favorite word?
My favorite word is football because I love playing it. I like playing football because I like to tackle people and I like to run the ball. I play right guard, defensive end, and running back. But I only score 6 touchdowns. After I scored my touchdown, I go to my friends and hug them.
That's my favorite word.
Captain Huggy Face, show us what blithe means. That's right. Blithe means to be happy or joyous. Congratulations, Huggy! Blithe.
Want more Word Girl? Watch your favorite episodes and test your word power on PBSKidsGo.org. Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Cape not required. Word!